Okay, I'm going to set up a rear end a customer brought to us. It's a 7.5-inch GM, real popular in the 70s and 80s, and some 90s. Camaros all had these. They're kind of weak, but hey, whatever. They break, I'll work on them. So this guy brought me in a posi carrier and a new ring and pinion, and we're going to set it up using the GM factory Kentmore tools. I have the Jace 21777 kit. And it tells me what I need to grab to set up this 7.5-inch ring gear, which is right there. So basically how it works is you assemble the pinion gate setting block, which is that number there for a 7.5. See, that's for a 6.5, which I believe was Chevettes and other stuff like the T1000s. But anyway, so we're gonna set this up. This little spacer here is where the bearing sits. So we take this is the inner bearing right here, and we slide that over the top. And then this washer has a little concave on it. This is going to go on the back side of the bearing. So then we set this up in there, and this, believe it or not, will go right into here like this. So when we come back from a commercial break, I'll put the carrier block in here with the spring-loaded deal, and I'll have the dial indicator set up. Okay, we've got the arbor and the gauge plate and everything mounted. I've got these bearing caps torqued to 60 foot-pounds. I've got to make sure our arbor moves freely. And basically how this works is you see this little plunger here is spring-loaded. All right. So you kind of set this up like this. You take your dial indicator. All right, we're going to put it on this post. All right, because that's our dial indicator holder. And then we go down and we got to preload this guy. About 50 thousandths. So we'll go ahead and start tightening this guy up here. Okay, so I guess we'll set it to zero. And then this is contacting my plunger here. So we're just gonna push this in and we're gonna preload it 50 thousandths. All right, which is right there. I'll adjust it here again. This is not that critical. You just got to be into the plunger. We want to make sure our dial indicator is into our plunger. So, all right. So now that we've done that, now we've got to zero our indicator. So what we'll do is we'll move it to zero. All right. And then we got to find the point of greatest deflection. So I'm going to take my fingers right here and I'm going to wiggle my dial till I get the point of greatest deflection. And that's where I'm going to set my dial. See, I'm pretty good out of the gate, see? So, not bad. So basically what we do then is we're gonna rotate this guy off of the gauge plate, and it's a direct reading. And that's the shim we need, a 53,000 shim. So we go back on here. Make sure we are back on zero. See, I'm right there. Jump off, boom. 53,000. So that's the shim that's gotta go under the pinion. And that should give us a great starting point to check our contact pattern. Again, this is the Kentmore GM way of doing this. We've got all the tools to set up just about every GM and Ford and Chrysler rear end there is. So we use these quite often, so it makes the job very nice. When somebody brings something like this in, we can dial in just right. Okay, the next step is we got to set our pinion bearing preload. That's how much torque in inch pounds it takes to rotate this. So this is a crush sleeve design which means we have to crush the sleeve between the two bearings, and that's what determines our preload against the outer and inner pinion bearing in there. So the book says 12 to 15 inch pounds of rolling torque. So how do we do that? We use a rolling torque wrench. So I will put this on here and oops, right there about 10, see? That big line's 10. That's pretty good. We're not gonna argue over 2 inch pounds. So that's set up. Now we'll flip this guy over and we'll put the carrier in, and then we'll set up the backlash and the carrier preload. Okay, I got our carrier installed. Believe it or not, the factory cast iron shims, I think, are going to put this right where it needs to be. I can tell by the way it feels. One thing to note, you need a shim driver for these. This is the Kentmore J25588. This does a 7.5 and 8.5 rear ends. You got to drive these in and the bearings with this. If you don't do that on the factory shims, you will break them in half. When they get wedged in, they're crooked. If you start beating on them with a hammer, it's game over. So it's nice to have the factory tools. But I'm gonna go ahead and torque the caps, and we're gonna go ahead and hook up a dial indicator and check our backlash of our ring and pinion here. Okay, I've got the caps torqued to 60 foot-pounds. I've got my dial indicator set up here on a tooth. You try to get this as close as you can. The spec, according to our little USA gear, is 7.5 right there, is 6 to 10 thousandths is what we want for backlash. So we got our dial indicator zeroed right there. I'll move it. Look at that. I'd say it's about 7 there. That's pretty good. Right on the money. We'll check it somewhere else. So we'll rotate it. Make sure we don't have any run out or anything going on. We'll zero our indicator. Just want to make sure you're into the indicator a little bit. You can tell by this, see, I'm into the indicator. And then we'll zero it out. Oops. See, 9 there, 8, 9, that's fine. Cool. This baby's ready to burn some rubber, so that's a crash course on setting her in. Up a GM 10 bolt 7.5. Like I said, I used his, the guy had it all tore apart, the customer did, and he had it all cleaned up. He just wanted me to set it up. So I used his original shims. He didn't even tell me where they were. I just, believe it or not, guessed at which one should go where. And like I said, I've done a lot of these, so, and I could feel by the way it was feeling that it was in line. So that just comes with doing stuff. It's like anything else, experience. But that's a crash course on setting up a rear end GM 10 bolt with the factory Kentmore pinion setting gauges. Okay, our final check on our rear end is we're going to do a gear pattern check. Most of these kits give you some type of Prussian blue or some type of gear marking compound. So this yellow snot I just threw in there just come out of this tube, and they give us a Picasso brush. So basically what we do is you want to get the coast and the drive part of the gear. So this and right here, the side that's in front of us right there, that is the drive. The coast is on the inside. So what we need to do is we just got to play like fourth grade art class here and really get these gooped up. Make sure we don't miss any spots. I wasn't good in art, but I guess I'm good enough to do this. So that looks pretty good. See, I've got most everything covered in there. So now what we got to do is we're going to rotate this thing. Now there's a couple things you need to do. Well, one thing you need to do is Now, obviously, this is upside down, so the engine turns clockwise. So from the front, so counterclockwise from the rear. So that's the way we got to go. Now, what we got to do is we've got to hold the ring gear or the differential because we got to act like there's a load on it. You know, if we're running down a road, you know, there's going to be some tension on this gear. If I just turn this thing, you know, I'm not going to get a really good, without holding the ring gear and putting a little tension on it, I'm not going to get a very good pattern or a accurate pattern. You gotta hold this guy. So I'm going to hold this guy here. Well, hard to do by yourself, but hey, I'm gonna go ahead and do it, and when we come back, I'll show you what it looks like. Okay, I did my gear pattern check here, and it looked like it turned out absolutely perfect. This is the coast side, the side that you can see the little, where it looks like it's wore off a little bit. Right in there. So that's a coast side. You wanna be right in the middle of the tooth, and we are. We're not too high to the heel here, which is this side, or the toe, which is down here. And it's right in the middle. That's great. When you see a pattern like that, you know it's not going to howl, make all kinds of noise. The drive side looks just as good. See, it's in the middle. That's great. When you do, like what I was telling you before, when you check the coast side, you actually want to turn the ring gear with your hand and make sure that you're using your hand to turn the ring gear. Just like in a coast situation, the drive wheels are going to drive the pinion. So that's how you check an accurate gear pattern. But that looks really, really good. That's one of the advantages of using the Kentmore factory setup tools is normally you get it right the first time. Like I say, the gear pattern is the best way to check. But if you don't have the right tools, then you're changing shims, taking stuff apart, checking preload, checking backlash again. You know, it really takes a 20-30 minute job and turns it into an all-day project. So that's what you're looking for.